العالمين والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. Just a quick reminder for myself first and foremost, inshallah. Tonight, I'll be touching upon the first two hadith of the famous collection of the 40 hadith of Imam An-Nawawi, one of the most esteemed scholars in our rich history. The first of the two hadith are, each hadith is quite famous in its own right. We'll start with the first one, inshallah. This is the famous hadith that teaches us that works, deeds are only according to intentions. It's reported that the leader of the believers, Amir al-Mu'mineen, Abu Hafs, Umar ibn al-Khattab, radiallahu anh, he said, I heard Allah's messenger, sallallahu alayhi wasallam, saying, indeed, works are only according to intentions, and each person gets what he intends. Whosoever has migrated to God and his messenger, his migration is to God and his messenger. And whosoever has migrated to obtain a worldly means or to marry a woman, his migration is for the sake of what he has migrated for. This hadith was narrated by Bukhari and Muslim. Hadith number two, the elucidation of Islam, Iman, and Ihsan, also known as Hadith Jibril. It is also reported from Umar radiallahu anh that he said, as we were one day sitting with Allah's messenger, sallallahu alayhi wasallam, a man came to us. His clothes were extremely white, his hair jet black, and no sign of traveling appeared on him, yet none of us knew him. He came towards the Prophet, sallallahu alayhi wasallam, sat with his knees touching the Prophet's knees, put his hands on the Prophet's thighs, and then said, O Muhammad, tell me about Islam. God's messenger, sallallahu alayhi wasallam, said, Islam is that you bear witness that there is no God except Allah and that Muhammad is Allah's messenger, that you establish the prayer, pay the zakah, fast the month of Ramadan, and make the pilgrimage if you are able to do so. The man said, you have said the truth. We were all astonished at this man questioning the Prophet, sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and then confirming his answer. Then the man asked, tell me about faith, iman. The Prophet said, sallallahu alaihi wasallam, faith is that you believe in God, his angels, books, messengers, the last day, and destiny. It's good and it's evil. The man said, you have said the truth. Again, he asked, tell me about the state of excellence, ihsan. The Prophet said, sallallahu alaihi wasallam, it is to worship God as though you see him, and if you do not see him, he nevertheless sees you. The man said, tell me about the last hour. The Prophet replied, sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he who is questioned does not know more about it than the questioner does. The man carried on, tell me then about its signs. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, of its signs is that the slave woman will give birth to her mistress, and that the naked, barefoot, impoverished ones who graze sheep will build tall buildings. The man then walked out. He remained there for a while, after which the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam addressed me, O Umar, do you know who the questioner was? God and his messenger know best, I replied. He said, he was the archangel Gabriel, and he came to teach you your religion. This is related by Imam Muslim. SubhanAllah, so I just wanted to go through the translation of each of the hadith and then just mention a few brief points regarding each one. The first, of course, in terms of intentions, we have a beautiful narration from the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, in which he taught us that that if a person intends to do good, right, even if they don't do it, but the intention is present and it's sincere, even if they don't do the action, they're still rewarded a good deed for that intention. And if someone actually does the good deed, then they get 10 good deeds. So the intention is one good deed in and of itself. And then actually doing the deed is, it's multiplied by 10 at the minimum, subhanAllah. So to intend good, you get a good deed. To actually do it, you get 10 good deeds at the minimum. And then on the flip side of things, if a person intends to do bad, but then they refrain for the sake of Allah, they actually get a good deed for refraining from that mistake. And then if they actually commit the sin, if they actually make the mistake, then it counts as one bad deed. And even that bad deed, there's a slight delay in terms of it being recorded, subhanAllah. So the Prophet is teaching us that our intentions really, 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 they really significantly matter, subhanAllah. Right? So a reminder for myself, first and foremost, to tie this in with the fact that this is the first night of Ramadan, subhanAllah. What are my intentions regarding Ramadan? What are my goals regarding Ramadan? What are my plans regarding Ramadan? It's not enough for me to just think to myself casually that I want to have a good Ramadan and then the buck stops there. The idea is for me to sit down, to reflect, maybe even write it down. What specific goals do I have? How much Quran do I plan on reading on a consistent basis? How much do I plan on praying? How much do I plan, you know, in terms of sadaqah, in terms of X, Y, or Z? It all starts with the intention. And the Prophet taught us that the intention is important both ways. If a person intends to do something good, that's something that matters with God. And if a person intends to do something bad, but then they refrain, right? Maybe they get an invitation during Ramadan, regardless of Ramadan, regardless of deen, regardless of social distancing. Maybe someone, they get an invitation to go smoke something or drink something, whatever it may be. And maybe they're tempted to do that and they want to do that, but then they refrain for the sake of Allah. The Prophet is teaching us that they're rewarded for that internal struggle. That's not something overlooked by Allah Azza wa Jal. Rather, it's something significantly appreciated. So the Prophet, he's teaching us the importance of intention. So, you know, within myself, and I invite everybody else to just take a moment and to reflect, what are my intentions? What are our intentions as it relates to this coming month of Ramadan? If we approach this month with good intentions, and then we try our best to do good deeds, then it will definitely be a positive, transformative experience. But I have to start by looking at my intentions, and then everything else comes after that. SubhanAllah, one scholar, he said that if a person intends to do good, but they don't do it, they get good deeds. But if a person does a good deed, they actually do a good deed with a bad intention, then that actually counts against them. So you have this, you know, in one case, a person, they have a good intention, but there's no action. That's good. That counts. That's rewardable. But if a person actually does a good deed, and we'll get to this in a second, but then if they have the wrong intention, then there are actually consequences. Even if the action itself is good, but with the wrong intention, then it actually ends up counting against them, SubhanAllah. So the intentions are very important. And the ideal situation is to couple a good intention with a good action. We ask Allah to grant us good intentions, and we ask Allah to give us tawfiq in terms of good actions. Ameen Rabbil Alameen. Just two quick examples before moving on briefly to the second hadith, inshallah. The Prophet, he also taught us, sallallahu alayhi wasallam, and I think we all know the story, that someone gave water to a dog, and this person, they had a very checkered past, right, to say the least. A long list of mistakes, major mistakes. But they simply gave water to a dog, subhanAllah, with sincerity, of course, and as a result of that, Allah accepted that deed from them, and Allah gave them Jannah, subhanAllah. Right? So you have the power of this one good deed with a good intention. It completely transformed. It completely, you know, changed this person's status with Allah Azza wa Jal for the better. Right? So this is someone who, they may have had, you know, certain mistakes in their past, but this is supposed to give us hope and inspire us to do more good. It's not supposed to be the opposite where, okay, well, this person, they did a ton of, you know, bad things, they gave water to a dog, they went to Jannah. It's never an excuse to go and do one mistake after another, after another, after another. And then to, you know, let me just go give some water to a dog, or go do, you know, this or that good deed, and I'll be okay. That's the wrong attitude. A lot of it has to do with our intention. What's the intention that we have when we interact with the story? It should turn into inspiration, right? And it should be a story that inspires us to come closer to Allah Azza wa Jal. It should not turn into the opposite, right? So what are our intentions when we hear these types of examples, these types of stories? So this is a quick example of someone who did a good deed with a good intention. Allah accepted it, and Allah granted them Jannah. Allah says in Surah Al-Ma'idah, إِنَّمَا يَتَقَبَّلُ اللَّهُ مِنَ الْمُتَّقِينَ. SubhanAllah, that Allah only accepts from people of taqwa. May Allah make us people of taqwa. أَمْنِي رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ. And I want to contrast that with another example. The Prophet taught us, alayhi salatu wasalam, that the first three people to be thrown in hellfire, we seek Allah's refuge, on the outside, they were doing good things, right? The actions were good, but the intentions were severely corrupt. We seek Allah's refuge, right? And the Prophet gave these three different examples, the example of the scholar, the example of the shaheed, the martyr, and the example of the philanthropist, right? The generous person. On the outside, these are really good actions, but due to having the wrong intentions, they end up in a bad situation, and there's no reward for the action because the intention was absent. So the ideal healthy situation will be a balance between the intention and the action, right? I also want to clarify that it's not enough regarding something that's wajib, something that's fard, it's not enough for me to think to myself, you know, lackadaisically that, well, I have the intention to pray Aisha. Okay, that's good enough. That counts as a good deed. I'm not going to pray Aisha. It counts as one full good deed. I'm good. No, this is supposed to inspire us to want to do what's obligatory and more, right? And to intend to do more good. It's kind of like, you know, maybe someone would hear from a kid, I wish I had, at a fundraiser, I wish I had $1 million so I could give it in charity. Those intentions are rewardable. They're rewarded with Allah Azza wa Jal. So we have a clear contrast here. One person, they did a good deed, right? And it was sincere. Allah accepted it. They ended up in Jannah. On the flip side, there were three categories the Prophet mentioned, sallallahu alayhi wasallam. They did good actions, but due to having bad intentions, right? The wrong intentions. So the scholar just wanted to show off. The shaheed just wanted to show off. The philanthropist just wanted to show off. And they end up bearing witness against themselves on Yawm al-Qiyamah. We ask Allah to protect us from that situation. The action was good, but the intention was absent. And that ties in perfectly with the second hadith, famously known as Hadith Jibril, in which we have these different categories of Islam, Iman, and Ihsan. So I need to ask myself, what are my intentions regarding the five pillars of Islam, for example, right? Do I really understand what La ilaha illallah Muhammad Rasulullah, do I understand not only what it means, but what it entails? What does it mean to live my shahada? What are my intentions in terms of how I interact with my shahada? Is that a sincere claim? Or is it only lip service with Allah Azza wa Jal, right? So in terms of shahada, in terms of prayer, it's not sufficient just to pray. The Prophet taught us, alayhi salatu wasalam, some people in Ramadan, they fast, but they don't get anything out of it other than hunger and thirst. And some people, they pray at night, but they don't get anything out of it other than exhaustion and fatigue. The action of fasting is there. The action of prayer is there, but there's nothing going on inside. There's no effect internally. So it's not enough just to do the action, but it has to be coupled with internal presence as well. So let's reflect internally. What are our intentions in terms of prayer, right? What are our intentions in terms of fasting, in terms of zakah, in terms of hajj? This is internal reflection for the individual. How are we doing in terms of our intentions with these different things? And then in terms of iman, who are we doing it for, right? The sincere intention, mukhlisan lahuddin. أَلَا لِلَّهِ الدِّينُ الْخَالِصِ, to do it sincerely for Allah Azza wa Jal, for Allah alone. That's the primary intention. That intention is the priority, right? To do it for Allah Azza wa Jal. And Allah is the one who sent angels with scripture to the prophets, right? Let's learn about the prophets this Ramadan, maybe within our families, right? To prepare for the Day of Judgment. And along the way, there are ups and downs. There's qadr. It's a package deal. There are ups and downs. It's a roller coaster, right? Let's try to navigate as best we can through this dunya, through this life, in ways that are pleasing to Allah Azza wa Jal, so we have something good to say come Yawm al-Qiyamah. And then in terms of ihsan, right, to it's not limited to just worship in the narrow sense, in terms of acts of worship like prayer and fasting, but our entire lives can and should be filled with ibadah. So when it comes to eating, that can be ibadah with the right intention. When sleeping, that can be ibadah, that can be rewardable for good deeds, because the intention is to rest, to take care of the body, to get up for fajr in the morning, to get up for qiyam, to be able to fast the following day, right? We're not superheroes. We have to have food and drink and rest, so on and so forth, right? So just a moment, let's take the time, take a moment to reflect internally in terms of what our intentions are in general, and then specifically as it relates to this coming Ramadan, inshallah. We ask Allah for Islam, we ask Allah for Iman, and we ask Allah for Ihsan. So Ihsan is not limited just to prayer and fasting, but our entire lifestyles should be filled with Ihsan, bi-idhnillah. Of course, there are lengthy commentaries that we can all find as it relates to these really beautiful hadith, this really awesome collection as it relates to Imam an-Nawi, but the intention for tonight's reminder, inshallah, It's a little bit late, but it's like an espresso shot, you know, for myself first and foremost in terms of a little iman booster. It's not supposed to be a buffet, just a, you know, something small, maybe a little sandwich, some dal, a little something for us to chew on, pun intended, to just reflect upon. Maybe we can share it with our families, with our friends, you know, the hadith, and just talk about them and reflect. We ask Allah to make this a source of benefit for all of us. Inshallah, we ask Allah We ask Allah to accept our intentions. We ask Allah to accept our good deeds over this coming month. We ask Allah to overlook and forgive any of our shortcomings and our mistakes. Of course, the intention is to do as much good as we can, to avoid as much bad as we can. We have to go back to this dua from Prophet Ibrahim and Prophet Ismail. On one hand, رَبَّنَا تَقَبَّلْ مِنَّا إِنَّكَ أَنْتَ السَّمِيعُ الْعَلِيمُ وَتُبْ عَلَيْنَا إِنَّكَ أَنْتَ التَّوَّابُ الرَّحِيمُ. So when we do something good, we hope Allah accepts it. And when we, you know, if we try to avoid it, but if we slip, وَالَّذِينَ إِذَا فَعَلُوا فَاحِشَةً أَوْ ظَلَمُوا أَنفُسَهُمْ ذَكَرُوا اللَّهَ فَاسْتَغْفَرُوا لِذُنُوبِهِمْ وَمَا يَغْفِرُ الذُّنُوبَ إِلَّا اللَّهُ. To do as much good as we can and to try to avoid as many mistakes as we can. If we do something good, may Allah accept it. And if we slip, right, we ask Allah to forgive us and to shower His mercy upon us. Amin Rabbil Alameen. I'm going to go ahead and conclude with a quick dua. I'll start with that dua from Prophet Ibrahim alayhi salam. We ask Allah to accept our efforts. We ask Allah to accept our intentions. We ask Allah to accept our good deeds. رَبَّنَا تَقَبَّلْ مِنَّا إِنَّكَ أَنْتَ السَّمِيعُ الْعَلِيمُ وَتُبْ عَلَيْنَا إِنَّكَ أَنْتَ التَّوَّابُ الرَّحِيمُ. We ask Allah for goodness in this life and the next. We ask Allah to protect us from His punishment. رَبَّنَا آتِنَا فِي الدُّنْيَا حَسَنَةً وَفِي الْآخِرَةِ حَسَنَةً وَقِنَا عَذَابَ النَّارِ. We ask Allah for happy homes. We ask Allah to fill. Quarantine is difficult, but we ask Allah to make it easy. We ask Allah to fill our homes abundantly with His nur. We ask Allah to fill our homes with Quran. We ask Allah to make the Quran the spring, the oasis of our hearts and the light of our chests. Amin Rabbil Alameen. رَبَّنَا آتِنَا فِي الدُّنْيَا حَسَنَةً وَفِي الْآخِرَةِ حَسَنَةً وَقِنَا عَذَابَ النَّارِ. And a specific dua for a very dear person to the Sacramento community, Uncle Rashid Ahmed, who owns MS Auto. He's been in the hospital. He has not been diagnosed with COVID-19, but he does have some pretty difficult symptoms. We ask Allah to grant him shifat. We ask Allah to grant him a speedy recovery, a complete recovery that leaves no trace of any illness behind. Amin Rabbil Alameen. We ask Allah to grant him shifat. We ask Allah to heal all of those who are sick. We ask Allah to protect all of those who are healthy. We ask Allah to fill our homes with His nur and abundant happiness. رَبَّنَا هَبْ لَنَا مِنْ أَزْوَاجِنَا وَذُرِّيَّاتِنَا قُرَّةَ أَعْيُنٍ وَجَعَلْنَا لِلْمُتَّقِينَ إِمَامًا. أَمْنِ رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ. We ask Allah to turn all of our hardships into ease. We ask Allah to forgive all of our mistakes. We ask Allah to help us to approach this Ramadan with the right intentions, to take advantage of it as best we can. And we ask Allah to accept anything that we try to do for His sake. أَمْنِ رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ. سُبْحَانَ رَبِّكَ رَبِّ الْعِزَّةِ عَمَّا يَصِفُونَ وَسَلَامٌ عَلَى الْمُرْسَلِينَ وَالْحَمْدُ لِلَّهِ رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ. See you guys tomorrow night, inshallah. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.